Tim Panasiuk for Gibbons Motor Toys. Today we're going to show you the KingFisher 2625 Coastal Express. In short terms, it's a 2625 CXP, we call it, just so you know the terminology. This particular boat, just full disclosure, this is a used boat that we took on trade. It's a 2019 model. However, if you were to order a new boat today, whether it's a 2022 or a 2023 for next year, this video totally applies because most of these features are going to stay current since this was a relatively new haul not long ago. Showing you this particular boat, I will talk about the added on features that are on this particular boat. And I think that that would assist somebody also purchasing a new boat because these are all options that are available as add-ons. So with this particular boat, it's got the standard trailer, which is an easy loader, 7,500 pound galvanized trailer. It's got drum brakes, electric drum brakes. This particular trailer on this boat is brand new. The customer that traded this in elected to keep the trailer that he had under his previous boat. So this is a brand new trailer that would come stock with this boat. It's got slick bunks on it, and it's got 0 miles on it. The 2625 measures 26 foot 4 inches. We've talked about this in the past. Because it's a CXP version, the pilot house cabin, forward facing cabin, this boat is measured from the back of the engine bracket to the bow of the boat. So inevitably this would be the same length as the 2425 Experience, which is measured without using the engine bracket. The sides of the boat have got 1/8 aluminum, 0.125 aluminum on the sides, and the standard bottom is 3/16. This particular boat has an upgraded hull bottom of 1/4 inch. We'll show you that in the back. It's just a heavier upgrade on the hull bottom. Like every KingFisher, the paint comes within approximately 1.5 inches of the lower chine. Again, that's so that when you're beached onshore, you're not going to put chips in your paint here. The boat's going to stay looking like this for more years to come. As we're looking at this boat, you can see there's the odd little mark on it, but this is in relatively excellent condition. As we move to the stern of the boat, we've talked about reverse chines on KingFishers. They go right from the bow of the boat to the stern, full reverse chines. The advantage to that is along with the lifting strikes, it gets the hull up on step quickly, stays on step at lower speeds. And this is a 16 degree dead rise on the bottom, which you'll see as we come to the stern here, which really on this size of boat, it gives the best compromise between speed, handling and stability when stationary. Here you can see this is a 1/4 inch bottom. And as far as the usage on this boat, you can see there's a little bit of corrosion on the anode. That's not nearly bad enough to change at this point. If you do, it just unbolts. So maybe in another year or two. The disclosure on this boat would be is that the customer that owned it, he would use it in the salt water on the West Coast approximately 4 to 5 days per year. And then the rest of the time it was in fresh water. And Gibbons Motor Toys was where he had the boat serviced each and every year. And speaking of servicing, we can look at the engines here. So this does have the 15 horse kicker, a 300 with DTS throttle and shift. There's 130 hours on the boat. And besides the 130 hours, there is Mercury Platinum Protection warranty on this, which expires, I believe it's April 2nd of 2024. So there's still another 2 years of full 100% warranty coverage on both the 15 horse and the 300 horsepower. You can see that this has got hydraulic steering. It's got the stainless steel tie bar. It's got the My Wedge for traveling. Looking at some other options on this boat while we're standing on the outside, we've got the stainless transom rail with some Burnwin mounts on it. The boarding ladder is an option. And other than that, we'll hop into the boat to show the rest of the features. This 2625 has the optional extended roof. So as you can see, you've got really good coverage if you're working the auxiliary helm. Another option on this boat that's included is the 9-inch Simrad on the auxiliary helm. This has the optional easy clean floor, which we do on most of the Kingfishers that are 22 feet and bigger. And so what you got is you got fish tanks on each side. We've got our live well slash fish tank in the stern. And this is plumbed with an optional live well, so a great place for crab as an example. This is a standard feature on the Kingfisher, the slide out drawer. As far as the washdown pump hose, again, that's an option. So that's included on here. We've got some storage here below these three cup holders. Kingfisher's rolled edges with the dual storage trays gives you incredible storage space on the sides for extra rods, gear, gaffs, whatever you may have. As far as the door quality, we've showed this before, we'll show it again. There's just a release latch here. Quality of the doors, fit, finish, strength, there's no rattling, everything fits very nicely. As we move into the cabin, what we've got here is we've got the cold weather interior, which is an option. So you've got the felt lining throughout the cabin on the sides and on the roof. This has got the optional full head with a holding tank and a flush toilet. So that works right here underneath this bench seat. There's a privacy curtain with a rail up here so that you've got privacy. You got cup holders on the back of each of these bench seats on each side. This also does have the optional rear bed, which I'll explain here in just a second. In there is the sloper cover. So there's also an optional sloper cover included, which will go on the back. And as the name implies, it's a sloper curtain. So when that sloper curtain's up, basically all water and everything is shed off the boat. You've got these components right here that put aluminum rails in. These cushions lift off the back. There's another cushion in the bow. These cushions spread out and this becomes your aft bed. You've got storage on the sides and the trays that you can see behind both the auxiliary back benches and beside the front seats. You got more storage here with dams to hold your stuff on the sides. You've got, again, more storage in the dash here with a dam to hold your goods. You got more cup holders in front of the passenger seat. Under the passenger seat and the driver's seat, you've got these opening drawers for storage. This has got the optional Rivermaster seats with the Shockwave suspension. So that's the best the Kingfisher offers. That's the most expensive, most luxurious ride that you're going to get. You can control the air pressure on that, adjust them to your weight. We've got a 12-inch NNS Simrad up front. This boat does come with active trim. We said it's got digital throttle and shift controls. You've got a Simrad radio. It's got a 5225 XT antenna on the roof. More storage on the sides up top on the roof on both port and starboard side. More storage forward here as well. As well as this has got the Aurora package, which includes the twin windshield wipers up front. Compass is an option that's been added. And I did miss there is a net holder on the starboard side of the boat. We can show you maybe when we exit here. I'm just using a cheat sheet to make sure I don't miss anything. We've got stainless steel roof rails, plus we have the stainless steel, basically bus bar rail inside. If you're standing up underway, it's a great place to hang on to. This also has standard on this boat, it's an 85 gallon fuel tank. This has got the optional 125 gallon fuel tank. If you look at the bow up front, this has got the optional hawse rings so that you can put your dock lines through the raised bow combings to tie off to the cleat that you see beside the windlass winch, which is an option as well. So you got the windlass anchor up front. In the bow section of the boat, the one advantage of the CXP models is that you got a much higher and more capacity for storage, dry storage in the bow of the boat. This does flip down. Potentially you could sleep a smaller person. You just got to add a cushion to this. There is additional dry storage underneath here as well. And then you can keep all your gear secure by just doing this up. There is in-floor storage underneath the floor here, which is also a large in-floor compartment. Another feature on this boat is it's got the sliding windows, both port and starboard, along with screens. So if you're overnighting in here, you want to keep the bugs out, that option comes with this boat as well. So on the top of the boat, this is the optional net holder that you can see where the butt of the net goes here. The end of the net goes and hooks on that latch right there. Totally works awesome, keeps the net out of the way. I told you about the antenna. This has got the 4G SIMRAD radar on a scan strut pole with an external GPS antenna. The other thing that's additional on this boat is these welded D-rings to the roof. So as you can see, there's 8 of them, 4 on each side, along with the stainless steel rails. And then you can see you got your 8 rod holders on the aft of the roof. You've got a bow stainless steel rail, and basically to walk around this boat, you've got something to hang on to all the way around. So it's quite easy to tend to your anchor if you need to get out there for whatever reason. There are controls for the anchor inside the cabin as well. One feature I never mentioned at the beginning is this also has the heavy duty rub rail, which is a really nice feature, particularly on a boat that's used on the coast for bumping up against docks, etc. Hopefully you enjoyed this video, and if you're looking to buy a new 2625 or this particular boat, hopefully we've given you some information that'll help you make the decision on that. As always, please subscribe to our YouTube channel and like us if you enjoyed the video. We'll be right back.